What's up, everybody? So this video is for my buddy Richie. What's up, Richie? I told you I'd fucking send you a video. So Richie and I went to high school together. I haven't seen Richie in years, but Richie's been watching her videos and he reached out to me and he's like, Jay, I need some help for my, you know, getting my chest, my arms bigger. Do you have any advice for me? And I said, of course I got advice. The easiest way for me to give advice is to make a video because then I can take that content, repurpose it, and share it with everybody else out there. Besides, you're just a person asking. So if you have any questions, if there's a video you want, if there's a topic you want me to do a video on, do me a favor, reach out, because I'm always looking for fucking ideas of shit to do, and kind of you guys giving us specific things to focus on really helps us out with creating content for you, right? So we're going to start with chest first. And this is probably one of the most common requests we get from people is, Jay, how do I, well, the first one is, Jay, how do I get rid of this? Outside of that, one of the next common ones is, Jay, how do I get my chest bigger? Right, at least for the guys anyway. So now, usually what I tell people when it comes to making your chest bigger, the secret to having a big chest is having strong back exercises. And they're like, what the fuck does that mean? Why are you giving me back exercises? Here's the reason why, right? So when you do the chest exercise, what typically happens, most people's posterior chain is horrible. So they let their shoulder blades round out. And when your shoulder blades round out, you start like caving forward and you're not able to get optimal activation of your pec muscles. So you're doing your chest press, whether it's barbell press, incline press, dumbbell press, push-ups, whatever, and you're all shoulders and you're all triceps and you're not getting any activation out of your chest. And if you are getting activation out of your chest, you can't see the chest because you're so rounded forward that it looks like your chest is a lot smaller than what it is. So by adding, I'm a big fan of a 2-to-1 ratio. I try to do 2 back exercises for every 1 back exercise. Meaning I'm gonna train twice as many back exercises as I am chest exercises over the course of a week. This way I bring myself back to better alignment, all right? But by keeping your shoulder blades together and back, having a strong backside of your body, it's gonna allow you to get the chest exercises, right? That's a whole other different video for another time. I'm trying to keep this short because it's hot today and we had to turn off the fans, this way you guys can hear us. So I wanna do this before I start sweating like a fat kid in a Pop-Tart factory. I can say that, I used to be the fat kid in the Pop-Tart factory. So we're gonna do the chest lie isometric ladder, all right? So what's gonna happen is I'm gonna walk you guys through this exercise first real quick, no dumbbells, so I can actually talk and not struggle to get through it. And then we'll do a set of the exercises again where I'm actually showing you, the exercise with weights in my hand, going through the rubber cues again, right? Now, I'm using a Bosu ball by David Wecker, the Weck method, all right? I like the Bosu ball because I have a bad shoulder from wrestling. I remember this one kid tried to put me in an arm bar to break my shoulder. And then my body slid him on the ground and broke his collarbone. Different story though. But what happens is I got a bad shoulder, so I have to be very careful what I do with my chest. With a typical bench, I'm not able to brace the backside of my body and activate and support my shoulder, so I can't do a lot of my chest exercises. So what the Bosu ball allows me to do is really drive into the ball and give me a wider base to brace my shoulder blades off of, because the more support I get from my shoulder blades and my spine, better activation I get in my chest because I can drive my shoulders into the ball, right? So I like using the Bosu ball by David Wecker, the Wecker method. I get some couple rides, I put them up on a couple boxes, whatever it is. You can also do this on any traditional bench, incline, regular bench, whatever. You don't need this. I just think this works better. Anyways, what I'm gonna do, in my position right here, right? I'm gonna do a chest fly, but I'm gonna train my chest the same way I would do my abs, where just like I would do a plank for my abs, I'm basically doing a plank for my chest, right? So I'm gonna keep my shoulder blades together and down. I'm gonna try to drive my shoulders into the ball, right? And then I'm gonna come down, keep my elbows slightly curled and my wrist slightly curled, right? I wanna keep like this. You don't wanna do this shit because you're gonna lose the tension. I wanna keep a slight boat effect, right? And I'm gonna hold a chest fly position wide, not deep, for 10 seconds. After that, I'm gonna come to the top. I'm gonna do one tricep extension just to release the tension. Then I'm gonna come back down and I'm gonna hold it for 8 seconds. Richie, I hope you're getting this shit. This is good stuff right here. 8 second hold, I come up, tricep extension. 6 second hold, tricep extension. 4 second hold, 2 second hold. And then after the 2 second hold, after I come out of the triceps, I'm either doing chest flies for a set of 10, flowing, or dumbbell chest presses for a set of 10, flowing afterwards to burn out the chest muscles. Why chest presses? The weights you'd be doing for your chest flies might just be too much, might be too fatigued out. Chest flies still work in the chest, right? So it's a countdown set, down to 2, with an additional set of reps at the end to bring you out for a set of 10, all right? So we're gonna go to the next scene and we're gonna show you what this looks like with actual weights in our hands as I walk you through, all right? Let's see what it looks like. Now, Nick promised me he's not going to get my fat side. We'll see if he keeps his word, right? So I'm going to do the full version of this one. I'm going to start from the side. Now, I like using kettlebells better than dumbbells for this because the way they hang, I think the weight feels a ton better. So if I had them, I would get 20-pound kettlebells versus dumbbells. Well, we got dumbbells to save this video and use this, right? All right. I am a grown adult. I am capable of doing this. Let's go. Ready? 10-second hold. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, I'm up. I do one tricep. Bloop, right back up. Make sure you don't hit yourself in the face. That would suck. 8-second hold. Look at my wrist. Notice how they're tilted up like I'm arm wrestling somebody. I'm not letting them collapse. I'm going the widest path possible, not deep. That was 8 seconds. I'm back up. I do my tricep. Keeping all the tension in my chest. I'm only coming down as low as I can go with tension in my chest. Now, luckily, I've been doing these for a very long time, so I got a little more stability than the average bear. I'm up. I'm back. That was 6. I got a 4-second hold. 4, 3, 2, up. And as I'm holding that chest line, I'm driving my shoulder blades hard into the balls and coming down. 2 seconds. 1 second. 2 seconds. Up. And now from here, I'm going to do chest presses for 10, right? I do a twist. 10, 9, 8. I do a lot of weird shit. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and I'm down. That is the isometric chest fly ladder. We're basically holding periods of pause with the chest muscles, making sure I keep the tension on the pecs. Why? Because we're elongating the pec, we're keeping the tension there, and I'm working the weakest point, which is this tendon muscle right here, because think about it, when you do your bench, where does it go? This spot right here. So in addition to getting all the blood pumping and gorging to the chest, I'm also working that tendon right there, so this is where I get a stronger bench overall. So that's all I have for this video. Stay tuned as we give you some more exercises for my buddy Rachel to help him get his chest and his arms bigger. And like I said, if you guys have any videos that you'd like to help out with or a particular topic you'd like to see us do a video on, send us an email, drop us a DM, leave us a comment in the comment section below. And either myself or one of my coaches is going to reach out to find out what we can help you out with. And maybe your question will be in the next video you see on one of our channels. Thanks for stopping by today. See you in the next one.